worship this morning, we have our preschool here, our leaders. I want to turn around and you guys want to wave so they know who you are and we'll wave at you. And we do usually start our service lately with sharing our eyes and our hearts with everybody because we're still not shaking hands and we're not giving hugs. And that's really hard for some of us. So when we look at each other, it just brightens our day. So I know you have a way, now let's have a look at everyone else. Thank you, Megan, for back. Thank you, Vanelle, and thank you, Ed, for reading. Glad you're all here. On Sunday mornings when we gather, a lot of times Sunday mornings are crazy, and you're in a rush, and you don't want to be late for church, and everything seems to be going wrong. You can't find your watch, or you can't, your hair is going crazy, or whatever. And so when we come together, we want to push aside the outside world and what's made us crazy busy, and welcome the Lord into our space. Let us pray. Lord of the dance, I feel too self-conscious to dance. I don't know the melody, and I do not know the steps. I feel inadequate and awkward. Lord, be patient with me in my weakened state as I learn to celebrate my life here. Please pour out your power on me so I learn not only to hear the music of your heart, but to dance the dance of your spirit. Amen.
Amen.
We're here to worship the risen Lord, God. And if you just heard our pastor and spiritual leader, and if you looked at the program or the bulletin, you see that we're going to be singing a song about what she was talking about, dancing. And when we start singing those songs with the Holy Spirit, and then we've got all three of them, our Lord and God and the Holy Spirit here in the game, you can come out the aisles and dance. Would you stand with me as you are able, and we will read the call to worship. Dance, O God, dance so that I can feel your joy.
Dance before me, so that I can learn to follow.
Dance behind me, so I can hear your encouragement.
Dance beside me, so that we and he can step together.
Dance, O God, so that I can learn to celebrate my life with you.
Dance, O God, so that I can learn to celebrate my life with you.
Sing a song, number 261.
That'll be in the red hymnal, and we'll sing verses 1 and 2.
Dance in the moon and the stars and the sun. Came down from heaven above.
daycare staff and to honor the children that come onto our property and learn about life. Not always life out there, but life in the church, life in spirit. And I'll tell you what, these women that teach the children, they don't just teach them things that are in a book. They teach them heart. Each and every one of them is joyful and gives them direction in a kind way. And these children are happy every time they come onto our property. Well, maybe not the first couple of minutes, because sometimes that separation anxiety kind of gets them. But every time I see them, they are just full of delight. So I thank them for being here today.
I would like for our preschool daycare teachers to come up front, please, and board members, if you would please come up front as well. I would like the congregation to be able to see you.
Washes that every weekend between she and Judy. They wash the bedding on for the cots and everything.
And then we have Ed Ragland. Ed Ragland is a wonderful boy. Shoot, we got a clap for Bobby. Ed Ragland is a wonderful, wonderful addition. He is our, kind of like our community supporting, our cheerleader, and he just goes above and beyond. Ed, we really appreciate all you do for the preschool. Thank you. Who we don't have here today is Mary Lou Fuller. She is part of our daycare board. And you, Mary Lou is an expert teacher and trainer, and she helps with the educational portion of the daycare as well as being a good service person for us. And Ann Hinton is our longtime treasurer, and she does all the bookwork for us. The director collects all the money and collects all the records, and she passes them to Ann, and she's really important because she pays them their salaries. So I have a special little prize for you.
What about you, Bobby? Yeah.
Our excellence in the community. We are part of the First Things First Quality First program. certified. Our teachers and staff attend many workshops and trainings throughout the year to keep their keep current in their skills. We are a nonprofit business as well as a mission in the community. Our church provides building space. The center provides money each month to the church to help pay for utilities. Rooms used by the preschool and daycare have been in the past shared with Sunday school classes and can do that again. The center also, the governing board members and parents and children attending and volunteers have painted rooms, built cabinets, countertops, classroom, replaced the carpeting, upgraded the bathrooms, maintained and built playgrounds. With the existence of the United Way grant in 2013 and Pastor Bob Holliday's community contacts, we were able to raise money and get volunteers to build a new basketball court. It had been a long time dream to have a place for the children to ride bicycles and play ball games. So you can see we've been very active in the community. We continue to be active in the community, and it's all because of your generous donations and the work that goes on here and the dedication of our staff. So I wanted just to share that with you because it is truly a mission of our church.
Corinthians 4, 1 and 9, and 2 Samuel 6, 2 to 18. Present weakness and resurrection life. The God of this age was blinded the minds of unbelievers so that they cannot see the light of the gospel that displays the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For what we preach is not ourselves, but Jesus Christ as Lord, and ourselves as your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," made his light shine in our hearts to give us the light of the knowledge of God's glory displayed in the face of Christ. But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that this all-surpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed. Perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. 2 Samuel 6:2-18. Bring up from thence the ark of God, whose name is called by the name of the Lord of hosts that dwelleth between the cherubims. And they set the ark of God upon a new cart and brought it out of the house of Abinadab, that was in Gibeah, and Uzzah in Ahio. The sons of Abinadab drove the new cart. And they brought it out of the house of Abinadab, which was in Gibeah, accompanying the cart of God. And Ahio went before the ark. And David and all the house of Israel played before the made of fir wood, even on harps, and on psalteries, and on timbrels, and on cornets, and on cymbals. David danced before the Lord with all his might. And David was girded with a linen ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal's, Saul's daughter, looked through a window and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord. And she despised him in her heart. And they brought in the ark of the Lord and set it in his place in the midst of the tabernacle that David had pitched for. And David offered burnt offerings and peace offerings before the Lord. And as soon as David had made an end of offering burnt offerings and peace offerings, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord. Now we can dance in the aisles again.
Understanding that. You see, I'm in David's hand. I believe that God made these amazing bodies for us, that we can do some amazing things, and one of which is move freely to celebrate our life or to do something that we absolutely love, like dribbling a basketball and doing a setup, or playing ping pong, or knitting, or crocheting. There's so many things that our bodies help us to do that bring us great joy. Years ago, after the English invaded Scotland, England outlawed playing the bagpipes. And they also outlawed dancing. And the wearing of their colors, their tartans. They believed that dancing was unholy and inappropriate, especially in a church. The people there were crushed. Dance was a part of them deep down in their soul, and it told the stories of their ancestors and their stories of the day. They believed that their dance was a dance that was pleasing to God. And yet, the consequences were so great that they stopped doing their dances. But they did not abandon their culture. They went to church carrying small pieces of tartan in their hand or had them in their pockets, so they knew where they came from. And when the clerics said this is immoral and they can't move any part of the body except their ankles and feet, the feet became the intricate patterns that the Irish people used to dance. They kept their bodies rigid, but their feet moved fast with speed and in time to the music. I was overjoyed 2 weeks ago to experience something at EAC. It was called the Journey of Dance and Music, and it was fabulous. People's cultures from all over the world, and these young people, I don't know how they had the stamina. I might have been done after the first dance, but over and over and over again, they did dances from all around the world. And when the Irish step dancers came out, their feet were just going so fast, but they kept their hands in fists and they would just dance with their feet. All from way back in the day when it became a part of their culture not to dance, but to dance. Many cultures from Scotland and Africa and Japan to the Wild West, dances were performed on that stage. All the cultures are rich. Every culture is rich in sacred dance. The dance of the hunting, the dance of praising God for the bounty, harvest festivals and dancing as they bring in the grain. Dances to teach history of the people, holy and liturgical dances of praise. But the dances of the Irish tell the story of being held captive and lived through repression, yet they continued to do their step dancing. The hymn that we were singing earlier, that we'll sing the rest of in a little bit, Lord of the Dance, there's a phrase in it that says, it's hard to dance with the devil on your back. It's hard to dance with the devil on your back. Social, political, and historical events threaten to change the culture of people all over the world. But dancing is not gone, nor will it ever. It is a creative force that leads the people to dance, to use their bodies with joy, even in captivity, where the people are literally stripped of everything they own. The impressors cannot take away their ability to respond to our Maker through dance. Dance then wherever you may be. I am the Lord of the dancing. Dancing is not freedom from difficulties. It is faith in the midst of difficulties. We know as Christians that our faith is not lived in constant joy. It's lived in prayer to help us get through those tough times, rejoicing in the bountiful times that we've had in the past and that we know God will bless us with in the future. Ray Buckley is an author of the book, It's Hard to Dance with the Devil on Your Back. And he writes, the gospel is precisely about the dance. It is precisely about who can dance. It is about the right to dance. It's not about the difficult times. It is also about the dance of real and pure joy. The dance of the Spirit is real. It's about discipleship that is real. It's about teaching others about our history in the creation that is real. No matter where we're from, where our ancestors hailed from, we all have that desire to move and to dance and to be filled with joy. It's our joy to teach others about the love of our amazing God who wants a personal relationship with us. Imagine what that would be in your lives to be able to talk inside your body and mind or outside your body and mind to your Creator. And even if when you're doing it, you're just swaying back and forth a little bit, or forward and back a little bit, you've become the dance with God. Imagine the Lord of the dance today reaching out his hand and extending an invitation to each of us here and to each of you at home. When we respond with a heart of delight and leap onto God's dance floor, we can begin to move as one in Christ, in mind, in body, and in soul. Doesn't that dance sound wonderful? All the pieces coming together in your life and filling you with joy. And God looks down and says, it is good. Now I know it took me years to be comfortable in my own body. Sometimes I'm still not. But I still love to dance. Absolutely love it. And at this stage in my life, dancing has changed. It's the delight of others, watching them dance, or watching people sway to the music or tapping their toes or clapping their hands. Though I have a little Irish in me, I will not be moving my feet in worship. But my hands and arms will be ready to welcome, sometimes ready to sign about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and sometimes to hug you, to put my hand on your shoulder, and to let you know that you are special. You are purely holy in the sight of the Lord. And when God says, my grace is sufficient for you, my power is made perfect in your weakness, when you are weak, God is strong. No matter where or when or if you move your body, when you praise God during this Lenten season, We will all end up at the same Easter celebration. May our music and our prayers and offerings surround God like a fine mist. And let our light shine in the darkness and our hearts leap with joy as we dance and sing and praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
This is a special time in our worship service. It's a time when we literally become one with our God, where God enters our bodies in a special and unique way. Everybody here is welcome to celebrate Holy Communion with us. You don't have to be a United Methodist, and if it's your first time to take communion, go ahead with the Spirit of the Lord in you. We hope that faith grows in all of your life. This is a sung version of the Lord's Prayer, and we'll move through the service together. The Lord be with you. And it it took him 3 days to die on that cross. And they took him down from that cross. They put him in the cave where they put people to decarnate. They put them in there until all the flesh is gone. They put him in, they rolled a big rock in front of him, and they had guards standing at the gate because they did not want anyone to steal the body. That body of Christ, that voice, those arms that encircle us when we need a hug, that voice that we hear when God says everything's going to be all right, our Jesus. Today, together, we take this little piece of bread in remembrance of his incarnate body. When all of the disciples got together after Jesus' death, they were sitting at table, all together in mourning. You know what that feels like, right? When you've lost someone you love. They were all sitting there and they were sharing some stories about Jesus and what he did for them and what he did for others in their midst. Healing a blind person, making a lame man who'd never walked a day in his life get up and dance, children surrounding him with joy. He was truly a delightful and loving and compassionate and kind man. We call him the Christ because he changed lives wherever he went. And we are living proof here today that he's still changing lives. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So the blood that coursed through the body of Christ today courses through ours as well. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Amen. Amen. It's a part of our custom that comes right from the Lord himself. He prayed with people. They asked him, Lord Jesus, pray for my mother. She's ill. Pray for my son. He's dying. And Jesus would pray and sometimes reverse completely what had happened, the tragedy that happened in the family's life. It's become a part of our custom that we bring before the Lord and before the congregation prayers that we have, things that we might be struggling with, or things we know other people are struggling with. And so if you have a prayer, go ahead and raise your hand, and Rachel's going to bring the microphone to you. When you use the microphone, turn it this way toward your mouth. Paula?
Good morning. I would like to thank all of you for your prayers for my son-in-law. He had his
check. He had his MRI checkup this last week, and he's stable. He's able to continue his chemotherapy 5 days a month, and is doing, still living a very quality life, which is wonderful. Also, Thanksgiving for me, I had a sonogram on my thyroid because I had a test that indicated there could be a problem there, and there were no nodules. I will continue to have it checked out for surgery here for 5 years, but that's good news. So my thanks and prayers and joy.
Prayers for all those who are undergoing chemotherapy. A special part of our family will start tomorrow. And my son was down, Patrick, and it's been almost 8 years since he's diagnosed with Parkinson's, but he's doing very, very, very well. Thanks be to God.
Amen. Lord, we ask that you would continue to increase the strength of Patrick, that he would walk in your ways all of his life.
World peace, especially to those people in Ukraine.
Lord, we live in such safety here that we really have no idea what bombing our country and our state and our town. We just have no idea what that would be like, and it terrifies us to think of it. Lord, give each of the people who are frightened today a spark of your divine, that they would feel the warmth of your safety deep down inside.
Good morning.
Good morning,
Debbie. I'm super stoked, excited, on fire. I was able and privileged to go to a 3-hour meeting training yesterday for the Alpha program. So I am so excited. Hopefully, I can bring it into this world and make sure that some of our people are joining me in prayer. Thank you.
Thank you. And Lord, we do pray for the Alpha program. This is a Bible study, a heart study, a mind study, and getting together with other people to get to know others and have fellowship with them. So we'll have more on that at another time.
Prayers for Church of the Good Shepherd in Kearney, Arizona. Judy and I are going next Sunday to have a meeting with the Nomads organization to start a new partnership in ministry with that church. So this is our last Sunday here.
Oh. I didn't cue them to do that. That was natural.
Until next year. We'll be back next year, hopefully.
You'll be back next November. Well, thank you for all the work you're doing with Kearney. This may end up being a wonderful thing for us to be involved in helping the United Methodist Church in Kearney with their property and with their worship and soul.
Yes. My daughter just had her checkup with her dermatologist after surgery to remove a melanoma from her arm. And she's got a clean bill of health. They got it all. No problems. It's healed up. So I want to thank all the people that had been praying for her. As we all know, prayer works.
Yes.
Yes, it does.
Thank you, Kelly. And Monica?
I have 4 grandchildren, and the third one is extremely autistic, nonverbal, lots and lots of problems. And my son Lance texted yesterday that, and he's that age, 6, when they're supposed to lose their teeth. His adult tooth is coming in behind his other teeth, under his tongue.
Oh.
And I don't know if you can imagine, it takes 3 adults to hold him down when they just need to do a blood test because of other problems. He has seizures. And I can't even begin to imagine how they're going to deal with this. So prayers for Lance and prayers for Cole.
Lord, we Lord God, we're so thankful for Cole. We're so thankful for Cole, and you know that he is struggling in his mind and in his body, but we know, Lord, that you protect his soul. Continue to speak clearly to him. Give him little pieces of peace that he would grow into knowing you and knowing that peace that passes under all understanding. Amen.
Just prayers for all those that are traveling during this spring break week.
Oh, it's spring break? Boy, I guess I've been out of school way too long. Oh, boy, I remember spring break. That was a blast. So, yes, Lord, you know that people are going to be out and about and out on the mountain and in the creeks and doing motocross and skateboarding and all sorts of fun things. And we just ask that you would allow them to feel the warmth of your sun and give thanks, and that you would allow their bodies to stay healthy and their minds to be filled with joy. Okay. Nice to see you. Lord Almighty, thank you for this opportunity to join together as your family, each and every one of us a part of it. And Lord, we ask that as we rise from the seats and walk out these doors, that we would remember John Wesley's advice: the world is my parish. When we think about the world being our parish, our deeds change. The way we look at the world and God's beloved changes. So go in peace and serve the Lord. And thank you for joining us online. I'm so glad you did. Anytime you want to come and visit in person, we welcome you.